Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's see how in vivo study data can be used to generate dose response curves. By the end of this video, students will be able to describe in vitro concentration response data, describe in vivo response time data, and generate dose response curves from the response time data. On the screen, we have a graph. This graph shows the effect of a ligand on a receptor against the logarithm of the ligand concentration. So this particular ligand is the endogenous ligand for the receptor, a full agonist. This curve is generated from multiple concentration points. The collective points form a curve, a sigmoidal curve. Generally, when you see a sigmoidal curve like this, the x-axis will be a logarithmic axis. This kind of curve, response log concentration, typically arises from in vitro assays. In vivo response curves tend to look a bit differently. Here is a typical set of hypothetical in vivo data. Let's say we are developing a weight loss drug, and we are dosing the drug in obese mice as our animal disease model for 28 days, as seen on the x-axis. The biomarker we are following is mass of the mouse. That's our y-axis. We could follow other biomarkers, like plasma glucose, but here we are just looking at mass of the animal. We have several data sets on this graph. Typically, you have a negative control group, a group that receives a placebo treatment, no drug, the vehicle group. That's the black line. As you can see, during the study, the mass of the vehicle mice was essentially unchanged. Not always, but often you include a group of animals that receive a known treatment. This is a positive control group receiving a standard of care, SOC. That's the dotted line, and those animals did lose some weight. The other lines in different colors represent different dosing levels of our compounds. Doses are normally reported as mgs-per-kg. The amount of weight loss by the dosed animals did vary and does seem to correlate with the amount of the dose. While this type of data is very informative, let's see how these final data points, just the day 28, points for the four dosing groups can be visualized differently. From these four data points, we can generate a dose response curve. To the lower left is a set of points and axes. On the x-axis is log of the dose, and the y-axis is percent mass of the animal relative to the vehicle group. These four points generate a curve, a dose response curve that has a sigmoidal shape as long as the dose range of the test groups gives a representative range of responses. So the lower dose gives less change in mass than the higher dose. And going from 10 mg per kg to 20 mg per kg gives some decrease in mass, but it seems that the effect is starting to plateau. We can change the y-axis to report percent weight loss relative to the vehicle group. The curve is now an upward sigmoid, but ultimately communicates the same information. The lower doses give less weight loss, and a 20 mg per kg dose likely gives close to the maximal response.
We have reviewed in vitro concentration response curves. We have described in vivo response time data with positive and negative controls. Finally, we used the response time data to generate dose response curves.
I hope you have a better understanding of dose response curves. If you have any questions, please do not hesitate to ask them in the comments section below the video. Take care.